here at the Jacksonville National Cemetery to pay their respects to their loved ones. Lynn Herndon is here to honor her father.
What would his legacy be?
Well, I already know what his legacy was. It was God bless America. He said that at my brother's wedding. He said it everywhere. He was just a very honorable man. He was all about his country, for sure.
Ebony Richburg and her daughter came to lay a rose at a friend's grave who recently died.
It makes me feel a little overwhelmed with joy. It's just sad that, you know, the price that we have to pay to come together, the reason that we're here today.
The roses came from local Boy Scouts and the Memorial Day Flowers Foundation.
David E. Aguala, may he rest in peace.
All of the veterans and people in service who are fighting for our country, they should get the respect that they deserve.
These boys handed out thousands of roses to families or placed them on the graves themselves. The scouts say it's an honor for them to be a part of the ceremony.
It's, you know, one of the points of the scout oath that, you know, that we'll do our best for God and our country.
The flowers came from Memorial Day Flowers Foundation. The man behind today's effort says it's dear to his heart.
I'm an immigrant to this country, and I'm just very thankful for being a citizen. And I just wanted to find a way to give back to this great nation of ours. And the best way to do that is honor the people who have paid an ultimate sacrifice in order for our freedoms.
If you want to donate to make next year's ceremony even better with more flowers for every grave, go to memorialdayflowers.org. Ashley Spicer, Channel 4, the local station.